So hello everyone, welcome to another video at my channel. And in today's video, we are going to be talking about car audio. From today, I'm going to starting a series in which I would be covering each and every topic related to car audio. That would be including from the head units, amplifiers, wirings, connections, speakers, woofers, and you name it about car audio, or I'm going to cover it in every video that I'm going to be posting from now. So for today's video, I am just going to be talking about amplifiers, that why do we need an amplifier, or why people install amplifiers in their cars. Amplifiers also are of many types, mono, two channel, three channel, four channel, depending upon on the wattage and the speaker outputs or the speakers that are going to be connected to that amplifier. I would be covering each and every aspect in separate videos, but today I'll just cover why do we need an amplifier in our car. So one is that the company gives, that is the stock stereo that the company provides. It may be a touch screen or it may not be a touch screen, and company may or may not provide the speakers in the doors. So that is a really basic setup. When we use the output from our car head unit, so basically the power output is really limited there. The max is around 20 to 25 watts per speaker, that is per channel. So when we use an aftermarket amplifier, so what helps is the power can be tuned to the speaker that is going. That means you can arrange the bass level, the treble, how many frequencies, either all frequencies should come or any limited frequencies should come from the speaker. And the second thing is when you install the heavy speakers, that is components, I'll be covering what components are exactly. So when you install heavy speakers in your doors or you install woofers, then the stereo cannot provide that much output to run those speakers. So what the stereo does, it plays the audio file and it converts into a format that the amplifier can read. And then the amplifier amplifies the signal by itself. For that, we provide power directly from the battery and a ground. I'll also be covering that how to make connections for that. I'll be showing you an amplifier right now, so you can get a better idea for that. So as I told, as you can see, this is a Pioneer 1000 watt amplifier. That is 1000 watts. That means it's a four channel amplifier. That means it outputs 250 watt as peak wattage at each channel and around 60 to 65 watt RMS per channel. I'm going to explain these terms in depth obviously in future videos, but just to show you an amplifier, this is a Pioneer amplifier. You can see basically this is here are all the inputs, this is all the power inputs, this is the output. For all the four channels, I've basically connected the woofer to this by using a bridge mode. And here are the RC inputs that is coming from the stereo. That is a signal that the amplifier is amplifying actually. And these are all the controls that you have. So that's all for an amplifier.
So now I hope you understand that why do we need an amplifier in a car. As I told, for better performance of the speakers, or if you're upgrading our speakers for better sound quality. Basically, if people like to listen to bass specifically, then the amplifiers and this whole concept comes into play. Otherwise, if you're a very average listener that you do not emphasize a lot of on bass, or maybe you're okay with your current situation, so that installing an amplifier would not work. For an example, if you own a car in which company has provided the company fitted speakers and the stereo, so by adding an amplifier in this, you would not increase much, because the music level or the bass level or the quality would not increase. Otherwise, it would actually decrease in that case, because your door speakers that company has provided, they are sort of very low quality. So if you provide high wattage from the amplifier to those speakers, you're going to end up ripping them off. So it's no point investing an amplifier for your car if you are not going to upgrade your speakers and all. So I think that's enough for this video. I hope you got a basic idea that what is an amplifier and why is it used in a car. Now in future videos, I would be covering a lot of about the car audio, as I've already told. So stay tuned for those videos, and thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.